Hey, what can I say about Social Distortion other than I love them? They're great. I've loved them since I was a kid, and my brother introduced me to them. I've seen them play live. And they probably were one of the starters of my obsession with artistic skeletons. So there's that. But I also grew up part Mexican in Phoenix, so that skeletons are all over the place. What I really like about Social Distortion is they capture something which I think is common to people who are perhaps attracted to their music. As a seminal West Coast punk band coming out of the 80s and then really incorporating a lot of rockabilly after that, is that if you're of the disposition where you automatically, especially growing up, go to the rebellious. And sometimes that can be a very lonely feeling. It captures that, but also that growing up is a process in which you think about how to turn your rebellion into something positive. That, I think, Social D did. Mike Ness, leader of Social D, did musically. We each find our way if you break through that process, and that's what I like. One of the things I like about them, also, they're just a great punk band. So I thought about putting on a shirt for today's video, but I figured that this shirt was the proper costume for Social Distortion. We're going to listen to a song called "Angel's Wings," off of the album Sex, Love, and Rock and Roll from 2004. And, again, Mike Ness, often writing about spirituality, is writing, I think, in the song about wanting to escape that painful disposition that some of us, maybe all of us, I don't know, experience. So here we are, Angel's Wings. Let's do it. Right there. Musically, the chord progressions are not complex. I've heard Mike Ness talk about this before. The ability of what he's able to do with such simplicity is really great. Great melody, Of course, great lyrics and a memorable chord progression that's diatonic, meaning it's keeping in the scale in which the song is, and yet does feel like there's forward movement to it. Always appreciated that. Just that groove. There you go. So another thing I like about Social Distortion that I remembered while in listening to the song, you know, I love punk rock, but I also love like really good solos. And a lot of punk bands stayed away from solos for the most part. And I know a lot of pop music now stays away from solos because who wants to hear just instruments or whatever. But I love them. And Social Distortion always represented the solos. That was always cool. I really think that their music, even though there's a lot of rockabilly influence, all punk rock is derived from the blues. But I really think that their music does have echoes, stronger echoes of the blues than perhaps other bands. They're just one of my favorite punk bands. That's all I will say. Anyway, all right, peace.